Welcome back to our Preem Buying Guide. In today's video, we'll be discussing all Japanese Preem aircraft you can currently buy with Golden Eagles or in packs. Japan has always been one of my favorite aircraft tech trees, and I'm really excited to talk about today. Zoot will be our guest today. If you happen to pick something up through the War Thunder store, please consider using our affiliate link. You can save 3%, and 3% will be kicked back to the channel. You'll also get a nifty bowtime decal. We really appreciate it. The first aircraft on the block is the Premium A5M4 for 250 Golden Eagles. This is a Rank 1, Battle Rating 1.3 aircraft. It is exactly like the same aircraft that you'll find in the tech tree, but with a pretty cool camo scheme, your premium boosters, and that's about all I got. Before we talk about the aircraft in-game, I do want to mention that this was the first production monowing naval fighter to take off and land on aircraft carrier. The aircraft flies, I think, pretty well. It does have some issues. It's an early tier mono wing plane, so don't expect too much out of it. Its landing gear are fixed, so you got a lot of drag there. It's not the fastest thing. It does maneuver pretty well for its size and weight. It's not quite a biplane. It can shake and bake, I'd say. The big issue that will be a struggle for new players is those twin 7.7mm Type A9 machine guns. It's not a heavy hitter in the firepower department. That being said, I do personally enjoy flying this aircraft.
The A5M4, it's a nice early monowing plane. It's not the best for high speed, although it does accelerate fairly well compared to other monowing planes of its battle rating. It does turn very well against other monowing planes, but any biplane will just still run circles around you. The two 7.7s are going to be a little lacking in the damage, but with 1,000 rounds, you will still be able to get kills with it. Also, rearm on a carrier is quite nice, although you probably will crash. I know I have many times while trying to land and take off.
I personally really like the aircraft, and for 250 Golden Eagles, if you're just starting the Japanese tech tree, it'd be a buy for me. Not a huge investment.
For 250, it's a nice starting point. It's a buy for me as well.
Up next, we have the Ki-27 Atsu Premium, which you can find in-game for 250 Golden Eagles. This guy is also at a battering of 1.3 and is a rank 1 aircraft. Has similar armament to 7.7mm Type A9 machine guns. Actually, to mention it, this aircraft is based off the A5M4. A little more modern features added to it, like a closed canopy and some other small things. But for the most part, they're going to play very similar because they are very similar.
The Ki-27, it's based on the A5, as he said. It's got the same firepower, the two 7.7s. 1,000 rounds. It's going to be a little slower than the A5, but I personally find it a little bit more maneuverable because it doesn't have that tail hook. It's denavalized compared to the A5, so it's going to be a little lighter and a bit more agile for maneuverability. At 250, it's a good starting point. Personally, I prefer the more maneuverable planes in the Japanese tech tree. This would be my personal recommendation of the two starter ones there, but you're not going to go on with either one. This one would be a buy for me as well.
So real quickly before we move on, I do want to mention that the Ki-27 is a very historic aircraft, and the Japanese love this thing. The next aircraft that came after the Ki-27 was the Ki-43, and the Ki-27 was the gold standard for what the next aircraft had to beat, and that was very difficult. The early Ki-43s were actually death traps because they had to make all these really dangerous changes to beat the Ki-27. So early Ki-43s had a tendency to fold in their wings on themselves when they made dives, which is why I kind of say early death traps. They also had a very skinny tail. The aircraft was just not as well structurally built as it should have due to weight reduction and trying to make something super maneuverable. That being said, 250 Golden Eagles, same response you're going to get from me from the A5M4. They're not the most amazing, magnificent aircraft ever, but I've got mad respect for them. Up next, we have the A7HE1 for 550 Golden Eagles. And if you're looking at this thing going, wait, I recognize this aircraft, that's because this is an HE-112, an HE-112B0 to be exact. The Japanese bought 12 of these aircraft, and they actually saw a little bit of service, a little bit of action, but they're ultimately phased out in favor of the A6M2. And that makes sense.
The A7HE1, it's got 220mm, it's got two 7.92s. It's identical to the B0 in the German tech tree. It's a nice solid plane. It's faster than most of the other Japanese planes at its BR. It's got very decent firepower with those 20mm guns, 60 rounds per gun. in the wings. It's not going to be fit in the playstyle of the Japanese planes, not a turn fighter to the extent that the Japanese ones are, but it's a solid plane. You know, for 550, it's a buy.
If you compare it to the other Japanese aircraft at 2.0 in the tech tree, you're not going to find something with this type of firepower, maneuverability, and speed. The closest thing at 2.0 to it is the Ki-43-2 with its two 12.7mm HO-103s, which I don't particularly... It's not a bad aircraft, but with the premium and the 220mm, that's the reason I'll say this is a buy. Up next, we have the Ki-44-2 Atsu, and this is going to be an interesting one to talk about, Zoot.
Yeah, it's quite an interesting little plane.
Let me first talk about the Ki-44, and then we will get to what this aircraft is special for. The Ki-44 is kind of the first Japanese fighter that they designed with the idea of climbing and speed in mind. This was the first one that took a step away from low-altitude maneuverability. So this is when they realized that they need to start countering some of the things like P-40s, P-39s, P-38s. Now, what makes this aircraft particularly interesting is that it has two 40mm cannons with 20 rounds total, so 10 rounds per a gun. So to explain this as simply as I can, they're basically automatic grenade launchers.
Yeah, that's pretty damn impressive.
Though you are limited in ammo, and it's only effective to about 150 meters in real life, and in-game it's pretty short on its effective range as well. It's not a bad aircraft. It flies a little wonky because of all the weight in the wings, as you'd imagine. I've had a lot of fun with this thing. It's really enjoyable to chase things down and just watch them explode. It's a very good aircraft that you take out for a challenge. Not something that's going to make a good grinder or get a ton of kills with, but it's something that you take out kind of to personally derp around in. For 850 Golden Eagles, it's a buy for me. I like it. I've had a lot of fun with it. I like the challenge of it. It's not easy by any means. There's a huge learning curve to it, but it is satisfying.
I've always been a fan of larger caliber guns on planes. I do like the challenge of trying to hit something with a 40 or 57 mil gun. It is going to be more of a higher skill required to get kills with it. And with HE only in the 40 mils, you won't really be hitting ground targets unless they're open top and doing any damage. It does get two 100 kilogram bombs, and it does have two 7.7 millimeter guns in the nose with 500 rounds between them. At 850, it would be a buy, just as it's stated. Make sure you're going into it knowing that it's not going to be a silver lion maker. It's more of a, I want to challenge myself. I want to become a better pilot. I want to set myself that challenge. But at 850, it's a buy.
And real quick before I move on, I want to clarify even more. Those two 40mm cannons are for anti-air use. Up next, we have the Ki-44-1, which you can find in-game for 850 Golden Eagles. And it also comes as the starter pack for the Japanese. You can find this aircraft on the War Thunder Store, Steam, PlayStation, and Xbox for $999, and it'll come with the Chihi premium tank we talked about in the previous videos, 120,000 silver lions, and 7 days of premium. This is very similar to the aircraft that you'll find in the tech tree, but this one, of course, has a little bit different camouflage and its premium boosters. As I mentioned before, the Ki-44 was designed for climbing and speed. This aircraft has two 12.7mm machine guns, as well as two 7.7mm. It doesn't sound like a ton of armament, but the four guns really helps with the burst mass. I really enjoy these aircraft. If you get it as a starter pack, I would say it's a buy. For 850 Golden Eagles, I would say it's a wait, just because you have pretty much the same thing in the tech tree.
Yeah, for 850, it is a wait, but to get it with the starter pack, with the tank, the silver lions, and the weaker premium, it's a nice buy. It's a decent aircraft. It's very fast compared to most of the other things around its BR. And those four guns, they will kill things with them. The extra addition of those two 50 cals and those two 7.7s does make a difference.
Up next, we have the F4U-1A that you can find in-game for 1,150 Golden Eagles. But this is essentially just a captured F4U-1A that is in a Japanese skin. It does not get any rockets or bombs. It is just a straight fighter. It comes as advertised.
You're going to see a lot of this Corsair when you're fighting at 2.7. It's hugely popular on the Japanese side due to those 650 cals. It's something no other plane will get anywhere near that firepower till later on. It plays identical as the American one. It just doesn't have the ordnance. At 1,150 at rank 2, it will grind out a lot of the tree for you. It would be a buy.
For 1,150 Golden Eagles, that would be the reason I would suggest it to you is if you're looking for something that will get you a lot of RP and some Silver Lions. There are several Corsairs in the game. I talked very highly about the British one because that one had some modifications compared to the American one. I would typically say wait for sell, but if you're looking for something to grind out and progress your Japanese tech tree, this would be a buy.
Yeah, the only reason I'm hesitant with it is the 109 coming up next. It's cheaper, slightly higher BR, but it's a 109.
The 109 that Zoot is talking about is the BF-109E7, which you can find in-game for 1,000 Golden Eagles. The Japanese actually bought 5 of these aircraft and had it delivered from Germany. They wanted to study them, in particular the DB-601, which they were going to use for things like their Ki-61.
Ah, they wanted the German engine.
They like buying German aircraft like the BF-109 and the FW-190 because they wanted to test them, see the performance of them, of course, and they also wanted to study how the Germans manufactured and built and designed things, so they would actually tear it apart and see how the aircraft were constructed and what materials were used so the Japanese could improve their own production processes.
Two of those 20 mils, while they're not MG-151s, they will still do a lot of damage. And two 7.92s with 2,000 rounds there. It's a wonderful plane. I do like the 109. The E-Series is probably my favorite ones. I've had a lot of time in them. And this one is unique enough that I would say at 1,000 Golden Eagles, it would be a buy. It's also really good for grinding out your tech tree.
Yeah, once again, it's not the most unique aircraft in the game, but it is strong. It'll help you grind out rank 2, rank 3. They're not asking the world for it, so for me, if you're looking for a strong aircraft in your lineup, this would be a buy.
I'm a huge fan of the 109Es.
This might be the first aircraft that Zoot and I are going to strongly disagree on, but the H8K3 is available in-game for 2,300 Golden Eagles at a battering of 3.3. It's still a rank 2. What don't you like about the Zoot, and then I'm going to try and counter you.
I like my float planes. I really do, and I'm a fan of the H8K2 in the tech tree at 3.3, but I just can't justify 2,300 for the K3 version. It's got nothing really I find better.
What? Its little pontoons float up. Sorry, I'll go back to my corner.
Yeah, the pontoons retract. That's fantastic. But for me personally, I can't justify that. I mean, it's a good airframe. It's got decent, you know, turret defense on there. It's got several 20 mils and several 7.7s. Two torpedoes, decent bomb load, two 800 kilogram bombs. They're very nice at its battle rating. But for just the little pontoons to fold up, I find it's a little much.
I waited forever for the H8Ks to be added to the game, and it was nice to see that one was added in the tech tree as well as the premium version. So you have the 2 and the 3. They're going to be very similar. This one has floating up pontoons, a little bit different configuration changes. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun if you have friends that get this, either the 2 or the 3, put a pack of them together, 3 or 4 of you, you know, and just fly a little bomber formation. You'll have a blast. It's a lot of fun, War Thunder. I think this is something that gets overlooked a lot, War Thunder, is sometimes we get stuck with trying to grind everything out or trying to get the highest KDR or whatever your personal goal in the game is. Sometimes it's just a lot of fun to get a few friends together, put some flying boats in a group, and just see what adventure you can have. So it's a wait for sell for me, but this aircraft gets a huge thumbs up. If you get a chance at it, go for it. Up next, we have the Ki-102 for 1,300 Golden Eagles. It is a battering of 3.7 and is still a rank 2, which is kind of sad. I wish this thing was rank 3. I was super excited when they added the Ki-102 to the game. This thing is a really sweet machine. It has two 20mm HO5 cannons, as well as two 12.7mm HO103s. Decent armament, great performer. Even at the price tag, I would say that this is a buy. I will shut up and let Zoot talk now. Wait, hold on. I got more, Zoot. I'm sorry. There was only three of these aircraft built. We're going to go through the history of this thing now, because I forgot to talk about the history of it. Three prototypes built. It has water methanol injection, as well as a turbocharger, to attempt to get better high altitude performance so they can go catch those pesky B-29s.
This was my first premium purchase on the Japanese air tree. I bought this plane after test flying it. I fell in love with it. The only other thing I like is Zero, but that's another story. The two 20 mils with 500 rounds between them and the two 12.7s with 500 rounds again. Really nice plane, nice and fast, turns really well. You know, it's got up to 250 kilogram bombs long underneath, so you can use it a bit in ground forces and then go back to air superiority and cover the battleground. Wonderful plane. It was well worth the purchase of 1,300 Golden Eagles. I'd buy this again if I could, to be honest. It's a buy from me.
In the Japanese tech tree, you have the F4U Corsair, you have the BF-197, you have the FW-1985. If you're looking for something that is more Japanese, and that's a good plane, this is a good plane. It's a buy. Up next, we have the Ki-96, which is in-game for 1,600 Golden Eagles at a battering of 3.7. Now we're starting to get into those rank 3 aircraft. I have quite a bit to say about the Ki-96 historically. This is going to get a little complicated, but the Ki-96 is based off the Ki-45. It has larger, more powerful engines, has a modified tail. What you see in-game is the single-seat configuration. They bounce between one seat, two seats, one seat, and then ultimately cancel the program because they couldn't decide what the goal of this aircraft was. Speak a little bit about that more. The Japanese typically like to have two people in an aircraft that had multiple engines, either as a navigator or as a gunner or a radio operator or something. They wanted to split the responsibilities and jobs up between two people, especially when you're flying a lot over oceans or open water. It helps to have that second set of eyes and that second individual to help you navigate, right? Makes sense, correct? You know, help you manage the engines. Lots of things to do, right? Very busy. What they learned from the Ki-96, though, wasn't wasted, and it was eventually rolled into the Ki-102, which was used for close support and ground attacking. But unfortunately for this heavy fighter, it was never destined for the battlefield. In-game, it has a 37mm cannon that has 25 rounds, and two 20mm cannons that has 400 rounds of ammo. So don't necessarily rely on that 37mm, but for 200 rounds per 20mm, I would say that's a decent enough armament to make it work. I personally really like the way the aircraft flies. It's powerful, it turns well, it won't compete with a single engine aircraft per se, but she can dance, and I appreciate that about her. At the price tag though, and the battle rating it's at, I would personally say it's a wait for sell for me.
At 3.7, it's not a bad heavy fighter. That 37 does only have HE rounds, so you're not going to be using it to strafe ground targets, unfortunately. It is purely a fighter. You will be relying on those 20mm cannons, unfortunately. But if you do hit with that 37, you will blow the other plane up. At 1,600, though, it is a little pricey, and it is a little niche, unfortunately. I would get it in a sale, rather than buy it at full price.
Up next, we have the FW-190A5 Premium, which you can find in-game for 1,750 Golden Eagles. This is the same aircraft that you'll find over in the German tech tree, minus the rockets. This aircraft was transferred to the Japanese from the Germans via submarine, and like I mentioned with the BF-109, it was used for testing to compare German aircraft to Japanese aircraft's performance and help the Japanese plan out mass production of their own aircraft in the future. In game, the FW-190A5 is a very strong aircraft. It's been one of my favorites since I started playing this game. I think they're asking a bit much for it, so for me personally, it's a wait for sell. But if you're looking for something to grind out your rank 3s and to get into rank 4 with, this is a very strong horse in that race.
At 4.7, it's blisteringly fast. It's got a really good armament of 4 20mm and 2 7.92s. It is just copied over from the German tech tree, though, so the price of 1,750, it's a little much, unfortunately. I would wait for sale on this one myself.
Great aircraft, just don't like the price. Up next, we have the Ki-61 One High for 1,750 Golden Eagles at a battering of 4.7. This aircraft I absolutely adore because it has two MG-151s, and to me, the Ki-61 airframe and performance married to German firepower is freaking awesome. Also has two 12.7mm machine guns in the cowling, but that's beside the point. More importantly, those two MG-151s. This thing and I have a long history together in War Thunder. It was in the tech tree for many years, and now they've added the premium version. So, that being said, if you want to fly it for free, you can. If you want a version with a premium booster, you can have that too.
At 4.7, you're taking that excellent German gun and you're putting it on a really good Japanese airframe. It's the best of both worlds. Like I said, it is available in the tech tree. At 1,750, it is a wait, unfortunately, but it is still an excellent plane.
Up next, we have the A7M1, which you can find in-game for 2,190 Golden Eagles. At a battering of 5.0, the A7Ms are supposed to be the replacement to the A6Ms. This aircraft's just bigger, meaner, louder, and orange. It has two 20mm Type 99 cannons in the wings, as well as two 13.2mm Type 3 machine guns. There is the A7M2 and the tech tree, and I believe that one will have 200 more horsepower. Is at a battering of 5.3 versus this aircraft at 5.0. So that's something to keep in mind. The A7Ms have been a very strong aircraft in the game since their introduction. So if you are looking at this aircraft, I would recommend playing the A7M2 first, seeing if you like that playstyle and the way the aircraft performs, and then possibly making the purchase to play the one at a little bit lower battering, if that makes sense. The A7Ms are a little bit acquired taste, but they are definitely a strong performer in game.
At 5.0, it is a more of a unique playstyle over what you'll be used to with the rest of the Japanese planes. It's a fantastic turn fighter. You'll run circles around most of the planes in the game at its battle rating. Those 220mm and those 213mm are very nice as well. I would recommend playing the A7M2 in the tech tree to start with, and if you like that one, then you're going to like this one as well. At a lower battle rating, it is really nice. It is quite expensive though, and knowing what is coming up later on, I would have to say this is going to be a wait for sale, unfortunately.
I do want to mention that there are only 10 of these particular aircraft built, and that's why Gaijin considers it a premium. For me, it's a wait for sale unless you really enjoy the A7M2, so that's my stance on it. Wait for sale. If you can pick it up for 50% off, fantastic aircraft at that price. Up next, we have the J2M5, which is in-game for 3,850 Golden Eagles, battering a 4.7. This is our first rank 4 premium we're going to be talking about. I really do like the J2M series of aircraft. Here's a fun little fact for you, Zoot. The J2M was created by the same individual who made the Zero.
I wondered why I liked it.
So the idea behind the J2Ms was that it was supposed to be a local defense fighter. It would be something that could climb really fast, get to high altitude, and attack the incoming American bombers. They were more concerned about speed and armament than they were maneuverability. In-game, though, I would say actually handles pretty good, so I don't think you see necessarily that reflected. So there were about 600 total J2Ms built between all the different variations. This 30mm J2M5 was a testbed and was never put into production. And we want to talk about those cannons real quick. Those are 30mm Type 5 cannons that have 84 rounds total. So you're looking at 42 rounds per cannon. And that's where we're going to knock on this aircraft, is that it just doesn't have enough armament. You don't even have a secondary machine gun or anything. You just have two 30mm cannons, 84 rounds total in the plane. And after that, you're going back to base and rearming. When you do catch something and hit it with your cannons, it will explode. Very powerful armament. Just not enough of it for me to tell you to buy it at that price tag. And so for me, honestly, this is a do not buy, because there's other J2Ms in the game that I feel are a lot better.
Yeah, at 4.7, the 230mm, they're quite nice. They've got quite a bit of explosive filler in there. If you do hit with them, you will do a lot of damage, but with 84 rounds total, you will be going through that ammo really quickly. It's a decent turner. It climbs really well for its battle rating, but there is a J2M5 in the tech tree, which has a more conventional armament loadout, and that would be the one I'd recommend grinding to instead. This one at 3,850 is just too pricey, unfortunately, for what it is.
So the J2M5 that Zoot is mentioning has four 20mm cannons in it versus the 230s. So the tech tree one for me is the one that you should spend your time on. Up next, we have the B-17E. At 4,900 Golden Eagles, and yes, that is an American B-17, and I'll real quickly explain to you the history of this aircraft, and then we'll discuss if you should buy it or not. So the Japanese were actually able to capture and rebuild three B-17s to flying status, and the three B-17s kind of traveled as a pack and were used for various different things. Most interestingly, they were used for training films. Some of these were training films where they'd have a Japanese captured P-40 escorting the B-17s, and then they'd have a Ki-43 pilot attack them, or mock attack them. They wouldn't actually shoot them down, but they show a Ki-43 going through the maneuvers and the tactics that it would take to take one down. So it's kind of interesting they were doing this type of stuff to train the Japanese pilots. What I found even more interesting is that they actually made promotional films of these B-17s and would play them in public theaters throughout the war. So these three flying B-17s were kind of celebrities, and there was thousands of pictures taken of them, many films produced with them. But what's really interesting is that nobody knows what happened to these B-17s. There are zero public records of these aircraft being found or what their fate of them was. Now, for 4,900 golden eagles, should you buy this aircraft and the current state of bombers in game? I would say no. Save your money.
The only saving grace for this B-17 in the Japanese premium line is you are generally paired up with Germany at this BR, which means you do not fight 109s anywhere near as much as you would while flying an American one. But for 4,900 golden eagles, I can't justify that as a reason to purchase it. I would avoid this unless you really want a Japanese B-17.
Up next, we have the A6M5CO, which you can find in the Japanese Pacific Campaign Pack for $14.99 on War Thunder, Steam, PlayStation, and Xbox. This is a rank 4 aircraft at a battery of 4.7. And I'm going to say it right now, it's a buy for me. There's a handful of A6M5s in the tech tree. The primary differences with this guy is that its cannons were switched out from magazine fed to belt fed, which allows it to have a little bit more ammo. And its wings and fuselage were strengthened to be able to dive at a higher speed. The A6M5 is a very infamous aircraft for good reasons. Good dogfighter, good overall fighter, period. Good armament, it's a blast to fly. It's something I think a new player can pick up really fast and easy. It's a buy for me. I can't say anything negative about this aircraft.
When I got up to 4.7 in the Allied Tech Trees British America, I kept dying to this so many times in a Spitfire and a P-51. I went over to the Japanese Tech Tree. I test flew this, fell in love. I bought it straight up, bought it. And then I grinded out the entirety of the Japanese Tech Tree with it, all the way up to the T-2 jet. It is the best Japanese plane, in my opinion, in the game. Those two 20 mils get an extra 50 rounds of ammo, and it gets those two 7.7s with 1,400 rounds in there. The pack at $14.99, you get the single player campaigns, you get 850 golden eagles and 15 days of premium. It's a buy. I mean, this plane is the iconic Japanese World War II plane, in my opinion.
Up next, we have the J2M4 Kai, which you can find in-game for 3,850 golden eagles. Sadly, when it comes to talking about World War II Japanese prototypes, testing, or anything that's kind of lesser known, there isn't a lot of history out there because a lot of the records were lost. They were either burned, destroyed, or were just lost to history. And the people who were involved in these programs, as either the pilots or the designers, creators, the builders, a lot of them didn't speak about what they did in World War II. And sadly, that history is just kind of lost. So when it comes to J2M4 Kai Raiden, this is kind of the case. I pulled up every source I could about this aircraft, and I saw almost every single one of them saying something different. But basically, this aircraft was used as a testbed and various different armament configurations, some of them having cannons facing upward, forwards, backwards, upside down. But it's generally stated that this aircraft did not fly with any armament on it. It was just a testbed. So it's a prototype, and that's why it's a premium. In-game, though, it has two 20mm Type 99 Model 1s and two 20mm Type 99 Model 2s. So four 20mm cannons max, not a bad armament loadout at 5.0. The problem with this aircraft for me is the price tag of 3,850 golden eagles, because there's J2Ms in the tech tree that you can fly for free. Is this aircraft different enough for me to tell you to buy at full price? No. But if you want a really good rank 4 premium, I would say it's a wait for sale.
Yeah, at 5.0 it climbs really well. Firepower with those 420 mils is really nice, but at 3,850 golden eagles, it's hard to buy at full price. It would definitely be a wait for sale, considering you can go and fly the other J2s in the tech tree.
Up next, we have the Key 87, which you can find in game for 6,090 golden eagles at a battery of 6.0. This was a one-off prototype that was designed to be a good climber and a very fast aircraft. Seems to be a repeating theme of trying to take down B-29s, and this was another project. The primary note on this guy is that its engine has close to 2,400 horsepower. This thing is all power. Though, sadly for it, it had a lot of issues, especially with its electrical and its undercarriage. It kind of has the same landing gear as the P-40, which is kind of unique. And it has a very similar turbo supercharger to the P-47. The aircraft would have been an absolute powerhouse if it got through its teething issues and was able to... I think they're only able to get 5 test flights out of this thing before the project was canceled. And it first flew in April of 1945, so it was pretty late to that party there. It does have 2 20mm cannons and 2 30mm cannons, and it also has the ability to carry a 250kg bomb. Not the greatest ground attacker, but it does have something underneath it. It's tough for me. That's a lot of money they're asking for this plane. So, at 6.0, I just don't think it's a strong enough performer to tell you to buy it for 6,090 Golden Eagles. And to be quite honest, even at 50% off, I think 3,000 Golden Eagles is still too much. It's a do not buy for me, strictly on the price they're asking.
It's a nice plane at 6.0. It's got that power in that engine. Those 220 mils coupled with the 230 mils, if you hit, you're going to get a kill. But at 6,090 Golden Eagles, it is far too overpriced. Even as it stated at half price at 3,045, it's still far too overpriced for what it is. It would have to be a not buy, unfortunately, although it is devastating with its firepower, just based on that price alone.
If you get it for 75% off, it is a buy.
Oh yeah, 75%, well worth it at that point, but other than that, it's a don't buy.
And lastly, we have the F-86 F-40 pack, which you can buy on War Thunder, PlayStation, and Xbox for $49.99. Comes with 2,000 Golden Eagles and 15 days of premium. So there is an F-40 in the tech tree that is basically the same aircraft in a different camo scheme. So right there, you don't have to spend $50 to enjoy the F-86 F-40 in the Japanese tech tree. Are you happy, Zoo? I made that disclaimer. They know.
Yeah, very happy.
Okay. I want to talk about the real quick history of the F-40 block of the F-86. 150 aircraft were delivered to Japan in April of 1956. Sadly, the last 45 aircraft were put in storage due to the lack of trained pilots, and were eventually returned to the United States Air Force. The final 300 F-86 F-40s that the Japanese had were licensed built by Mitsubishi in Japan. Now, the last kind of interesting note I want to throw on here, Zoo, is do you know when the last F-86 F-40 was retired in Japan?
Ooh. I want to say 80s.
1982.
Ooh. Early 80s.
Which is pretty wild. The big difference the F-40 has over the other F-86s will be its leading edge slats. Now that we got that out of the way, end game, it has 2 AIM-9Bs, 650 cals. It does have a pretty decent bomb loadout. You can carry 2 1,000-pound bombs or 16 HR rockets. Now, the question is the camo and the premium booster worth $50?
It is a copy of the Tech Tree 1. Personally, the Tech Tree 1 comes in a really nice white and blue camouflage, which is more unique than the one for the premium one.
I personally like the premium camouflage over the Tech Tree camouflage.
Ah, you see, it was the Tech Tree one which actually drew me to the plane. And then I saw there was a premium one and had a look at it. I do like my camouflages, though. I find it's just a little too expensive, unfortunately, especially since it is identical flight characteristic and ammo characteristic-wise to the Tech Tree one. I mean, you can grind out the early jets using a lower BR, a lower rank plane, the Zero. You could grind up and get the Kikas and such in the Tech Tree and progress to the Sabre that way. I just can't justify spending $50 on a plane which is in the Tech Tree. Although it does have that premium booster, which means you would get there quicker, it's still just not. It's not worth it. It would be a wait for sale for me, unfortunately.
There's only two reasons I would tell you to drop $50 on this premium. And that's, first, your time is worth more than your money. And if you just don't have time to grind up this aircraft, I completely understand why you would take the shortcut and use the premium booster to help you unlock the rest of the Japanese jets. I think that's completely understandable. Two, if you just play a lot and you want that premium booster, the only reason you're buying this thing is either to skip the grinding or to help you with the grinding. Otherwise, and it's going to be my final judgment, it is a wait for sell. It's just not unique enough to tell you to buy this thing at $50. I would like to real quickly say something about the Japanese aircraft tech tree. When I first started playing War Thunder, I had a basic understanding of Japanese aircraft, the Ki-61, Ki-43, the A-6M2, the A-6M5, kind of your basic Japanese aircraft, the ones that were mainline that were used in World War II. But when I started playing this game, I learned about aircraft I've never heard about. Things like the J-7W1, the Kika, the R-2Y-2, you kind of go down this rabbit hole of just really unique aircraft that you don't typically read about in the history books or see in movies and so on. War Thunder has really opened my eyes to the wonders of Japanese aviation. They had a lot of brilliant designers that were pushing technology in different ways, different designs. Nothing but respect when it comes to Japanese aviation. Even today, I'm still drawn to what they were doing in the 1930s and 40s.
It is one of the better tech trees for plane variety in there. I mean, when you think of other nations, you think of one or two planes, and most of those planes will be in that tech tree, and that's about it. Japanese, you'll go in and go, ooh, that's new. Ooh, I've never seen that before. Ooh, I've never heard of that before. And you'll want to fly them. It is really nice to actually get you more knowledgeable about history, really.
I would like to show a little bit of appreciation for the guys who fly Japanese aircraft. Several years ago, there used to be a really tight-knit community that all they flew were A-6M5s, M1Ks every day. And it was a pleasure to play with them, against them. Just awesome folks that were really good pilots. I learned a lot from them, and I enjoyed playing against them and playing with them. I'll say that again. Like, they were just great individuals in-game. Sadly, though, I think that community shrunk quite a bit due to not a lot of Japanese aircraft being added over the past year or two. There's been some, but I don't think it's been enough to capture people's attention. But I'd like to take a moment and thank those guys for making me a better pilot and opening my eyes to the M1K, the R2Y2. Those are some of my favorite moments making content. So thank you so much to those guys for being an awesome part of the War Thunder community, past and present.
Yeah. I mean, you used to be able to, when you fought the Japanese, you recognized most of the names back in the day.
Oh, yeah. There was always the same five M1K pilots. I was like, oh, you again. All right, here we go.
Yeah. I mean, I've got people on my friends list from back there. I've not seen them in ages. Just when I was grinding through it with Zero, it's like, oh, and same people again. Chat away as we're climbing.
Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, as always, please feel free to leave a YouTube comment. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.
Thank you for tuning in, and please remember, there is a link in the description and the pinned comment below. We'll get you 3% off the War Thunder store and a nice nifty Bowtime decal.